this is a part of the program of the president-elect, of meeting of the head of the missions. And this meeting specially was consecrated on issue of the coming 50th anniversary of the Polish establishing of the Polish-Filipino relations, and mostly we raised the questions of the food security in the Philippines and the contribution of Poland to assure the food security. And especially in the meat sector. Secondly, we are talking about cooperation in defense sector. And as you know, the Poland is producing the Black Hawks for the Philippine Air Forces. So it's about this and the possibilities how to extend this cooperation. And second president pointed out importance of the digitalization. So we are already presented in the Philippines with our IT companies. And I informed president that the Poland was the first digitalized administration in the European Union. So we have excessive experience in this area. So we are talking about the pandemic, post-pandemic economy that is a challenge, and the president is convinced that the world changed and will be different than what we had before pandemic. And we just priced slowly return of the Polish tourists to the Philippines, the and the increasing of the people-to-people contacts. It means in the context of overseas Filipino workers coming to Poland, that it's constant in constant increase in numbers. And secondly, opportunities for development of the cultural and scientific cooperation, and mainly in terms of the Polish scholarship to the Filipino students. So we hope that some decision will be taken soon and very quick, and the president knew about some problems. Some of them were new for him, but he promised to clarify some issues, and I would say, and he expressed the feeling that we can do more. I would say that there are a lot of untaped opportunities. So this is mainly the content of the discussion that was quite long, because almost 1 hour, and with the very important commitments of the president for us. So we are very grateful for this.
Good morning.
Sir, Poland shares a border with Ukraine. Has the instability in the Europe been discussed with the president-elect? And did you also discuss the president-elect's stance on the Russo-Ukrainian war?
Yes, we were talking about, in the context of the economic situation, about the Russian-Ukrainian conflict. I informed him that around more than 70 Filipinos crossed the Polish border from the Ukraine from the beginning of the conflict, and that we are working hardly to we're working hard to assure the export of the Ukrainian wheat, that it's creating there's a big problem in terms of the increase of the prices of bread and some commodities. So this was discussed, but there is no any kind of the trouble, I would say, on the border, because the war is concentrated on the eastern border of the Ukraine, not on the Polish border. And I explained that we are a second country in terms of the financial engagement after United States to support Ukraine. So it means in the humanitarian aid, military aid, trainings, everything, and the economic help. So this was discussed. It's all.
Sir, about Filipinos in Poland, you mentioned that there are still Filipinos who are still in Poland due to this conflict between Ukraine and Russia. What is the commitment of the Polish government when it comes to their security?
I don't think so. I don't know if there's more than 70 people crossed the border. So I don't know what was their itinerary after. So that's so we did what we did for the whole world. It means everybody can cross from the Ukraine, the Polish border. We are not looking for a vaccination certificate, no yellow book, no visa. It means that it's a free passage to everybody.
Thank you, Mr.
Thank you. Thank you.